And I say, hey, 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 live it like 面白くない
YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, it's your main man Wingdrops back again with another
super official food review. Can't dig it, baby, no you can't. Hey, listen, man, here at the Evergreen Inn,
love this place, by the way. It's Christmas season, and this place is my best favorite place in the area to get brunch. I'm here with the Friday Fellows. Got B fan here. Call me B. Hey. Of course, ever lovable Aurori 4. I'm just gonna try the food real quick. This place is god tier. Look at the portions. This is not all my food. We got the chicken fried steak with eggs and country potatoes, but also comes a stack of pancakes. Huge portions. Let's get into it. Start with the... Okay, thanks. New phone. Start with some of the potatoes. Pretty basic stuff. They look very, very charred, or they're much darker color than I'm used to. Let's get into it.
Alright, everybody, we're not gonna cut this up, we're gonna eat it.
Let's see how Chris enjoys his burger first.
Good luck with that.
Wait, it looks like a... It's so long for a burger. Dang, that bacon.
Wait, is that the tri-tip sandwich?
No. What bacon burger.
What do you think?
Oh, okay.
A big mouthful.
Delicious.
Damn. Good stuff.
Yeah.
These country potatoes, though, very meh.
Very meh.
The way they cooked it this time was very disappointing. Like, look at that. Look at the color on it. What do you think?
Very meh.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Usually they're better.
I think they're slightly overcooked.
Yeah, for sure. And the oil they use was probably bad. Just look at the color on that.
What oil did they use?
Or just old oil.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me get into the steak. This is some good stuff. Country chicken fried. Got some country gravy on top. Love this stuff. I always get this whenever I go to a diner. Let's get into it. Absolutely delicious. Mmm. Love it. Meat is nice and juicy, crispy on the outside. Still got that juiciness from the meat, and the creaminess of the gravy just pulls it all together. Delicious. And the egg, I mean, the egg's just an egg. I'll eat it on camera for you, but sunny side up. The egg yolk, cool. Look at that. I seasoned it with a little salt and pepper. Let's get into it. Look at that runny egg. Drip some of that over my steak. So good. Gotta give Evergreen Inn a 5 all day. It's just an old favorite of mine. And an old tradition of the Friday Fellows. 5 all day. Here. So Brian, what do you think about your food? You have the same exact thing as me, except with hash browns instead of country potatoes. And you have the biscuits and gravy.
It's a 5 all day.
5 all day? Yeah, 5 all day. B here had the Mexican burrito. Thoughts?
Muy caliente.
Muy caliente. I'll put a translator's note in there later for all you non-Spanish speakers. The waitresses have all in festive gear. Love this place. Overall, five all day. It's been the Friday, fellows. We're done here.
See you next time.
YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, it's your main man, Wingdrops, back again with another super official food review. Candy, you know, can hey, listen, man. Back at the Evergreen Inn. This time we have five people. Got the classic Rory 4.
Hi. Do you remember we were sitting there by the water?
You put your arm around me for the first time. Got Bevo. And B.
Good to be back.
Yeah, it's been a while for B. And of course, B fan. And wait a second. We have five, so that means our classic booth spot. We couldn't get there. So we're at a table. But yeah, just gonna review the food real quick. B fan ordered this thing on the menu called the catfish and eggs. You let me get a try. Let's get into it. It looks pretty good. Got some of the tartar sauce. Mmm, that's actually really good. I might order that next time. It's actually really crispy on the outside, but the fish is actually still juicy. I'd have to give that catfish a 4.5 out of 5. It's really good. I'm gonna review my food real quick. Ordered the hamburger steak, which is one of my favorites actually, with hash browns and eggs. You know, I don't know if you saw the last review, but last time I got country potatoes. Big mistake. Their hash browns are way better. Got the eggs poached this time. But you gotta try the steak. Let's get into it. So what you got here is Swiss cheese and mushrooms on the hamburger steak. I asked for medium rare. As you can see, it's almost well done, but it's the edge. So maybe it'll get rare on the inside. Let's get into it. I just love the taste of melted cheese, caramelized onions, and sauteed mushrooms on top of a hamburger. Absolutely delicious. Now I'll give it 4 out of 5. I mean, the overall experience of this place is great. Hash browns, dip it in some ketchup. Last but not least, I'm gonna try this egg right here. Let's see how runny they made them. Or maybe they're hard. I think they're hard. Let's try it. Yeah. They're poached almost fully hard. As nice, you can see, there's a little bit of... It's not fully hard, but it's not runny at all. Let's get into it. Evergreen Inn, as I've said before, masterpiece. Love this place. Great portions. I'm gonna review the specific dish. This hamburger steak, I'll give it a 4 out of 5. Really good. Though I do prefer the country fried steak, which is what B has. But this one is pretty good too. But actually, I would say the best thing on the table here might actually be B fans fried catfish. That stuff is actually god tier. It's been your boy Wingdrops. You have any last words, cameraman? Hey Bevo. Hey Chris. How's it going?
It's kind of bland, just getting the most basic item on the menu.
Yeah.
But you know what, I can eat anything. It's good as food.
A lot of times they say the best way to judge a restaurant is by their most basic dish.
Yeah.
How are their cooking skills, you know, pretty good.
Alright.
Yeah. Give the fans what they want. Give the fans what they want.
We're in a restaurant. I'm not gonna do that.
Good point.
We'll do it later.
We'll be back with more.
Have Bevo hold the camera and Pistol will come up under the table.
No. We'll do it later. You'll see it at the end of this video. So make sure to like and subscribe. And click on the bell for future videos.
Right, okay.
Do you need to do the sponsor spot?
Sure.
No, later.
Yeah, later. Any last words? We never see you too much, B, now that you've moved. But
I don't exist.
Yeah, I mean, Friday Fellows barely convene anymore anyways. As you can see, that's CGI as a green screen right here. Oh, shoot, where'd he go?
I have to remove the white edge.
Oh, my God. All right, so we're done here. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your main man, Wingdrops. We're here at the Evergreen Inn, the classic location. We do have a classic booth spot, but it's not the classic booth spot.
I don't know if you can tell,
but we're at the very edge of the restaurant, far back, because it's a busy day today. Today is March 17th, also known as St. Patty's Day. Not wearing green, sadly, but in honor of St. Patrick's Day, what I have here is the corned beef hash and eggs. Now this looks pretty interesting. I've never had like super legit corned beef hash. The only one I've had is the canned stuff, and that's pretty trash. So this is gonna be my first time having corned beef hash. Also got hash browns on top of that, double hash, let's go. And we got some sunny up eggs. Let's get into it. Thanks. Don't worry about it. Look at the consistency of that. It's interesting. Get that to focus. Looks kind of mushy, but let's...
It's very mushy.
Let's put it in my mouth and see how it goes.
I think it's a little undercooked.
You think so?
Yeah,
it is quite mushy, as you said. Chris got the same thing I got.
Hi.
Says hi. Do you remember we were sitting there by the water? I don't know how I would describe this. It's definitely got that signature corned beef flavor, like salted, pretty salty.
You added salt to it.
Yeah.
I need to add salt. I think that might be good. Thank you.
Here we go. It tastes pretty good, honestly. But it's just the consistency is kind of off. Like, look at that. Also, I'm kind of disappointed. It's basically ground corned beef.
Yes.
So, it's not... The structural integrity is not there, that's how I feel. So, corned beef hash could be the most disappointing thing I've ever had at Evergreen Inn.
Agreed.
Sad. I was really looking forward to this because I'm a big fan of normal corned beef.
Yeah.
Like the stuff you eat on St. Patrick's Day. This could be better. Gonna give it a... I'll give it a 3 out of 5.
I'd give it a 2.
2?
Yeah, like... Honestly, I've seen better.
Well, yeah, actually, if I gotta be honest, and just judging the corned beef hash as a... Just solo, I'd give it 2.5 out of 5.
Yeah.
It's not that great. If I'm judging Evergreen Inn as a whole still, though, really good. Like, look at all this food. I've reviewed everything else on this plate already, but just gonna eat on camera for you guys. We'll extend this into like kind of a mukbang, I guess, because no one wants to watch a video that's only 2 minutes long, right? You gotta make more money. Let's get into it. Hash browns are solid as usual. I'm gonna turn it over to my good friend B Fan. Probably haven't seen him in a while. What did you think about your catfish?
Straight 5 out of 5.
Straight 5 out of 5. Like it. Bring it back to Rory Ford here. Thoughts on Antonio Brown joining the Raiders?
Okay, so I don't like that he's a cancer, but I love the price that the Raiders got him. Like,
what was it, third round? Or
third round pick and a fifth round pick. You know, we basically got nothing, and we got some dude that is going to make Derek Carr have to prove it to all of us
that
we're going to win.
Nice.
Yeah. And then, I forgot the other free agent signings, but yeah, that was the big one.
As a Niners fan, I'm honestly scared of the Raiders. Like, as always, I want us to be the best in the Bay. Now with both Antonio Brown and Nathan Peterman, the Raiders are looking to be a real threat. I mean, what do we have? I mean, Jimmy G, hopefully he stays healthy, but, like...
You know, as a Raiders fan, after that 2015, after a Carr's injury, I gotta say that you can never count on someone being the same way they were after an injury.
Yeah.
Like, DeMarcus Cousins for the Warriors is a surprise.
Mm-hmm.
But Derek Carr has been quite the disappointment ever since that injury. So this is a blank slate with a good wide receiver that's not going to be as drop-prone like Amari Cooper.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if he is able to do something. We'll see if Derek Carr is able to do something in this new set.
Yeah, I mean, I'm crossing my fingers for Jimmy G. Hopefully he's still half decent after his injury. Well, we don't want to bore B-Fan here. What do you think about the Heavens feel? Sakura, worst girl, right?
Yeah.
Yes, finally someone who agrees with me. Eat it, Owen. But, you like the movie? Nice. Well, I think I've got my quota for this video. It's been long enough now. It's been your boy Wingdrops. Signing out. We're done here. YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Jeremy Man Wingdrops, and this is a very special episode. This is not the Friday Fellows. This is instead the Wednesday Warriors, but we do have the tradition, keeping it classic at Evergreen Inn with three of the core members of the Friday Fellows, the ubiquitous B-Fan. And of course, OTH Zamasu. I just want to do a quick review, just for old time's sake, because I don't think I've ever reviewed this catfish and eggs on camera before. I've reviewed every single item on here already. I have?
You have a better memory?
Oh, wait a second. Then this might be a little bit redundant then.
You gotta go through the archives to see if it's true.
Yeah, we'll go back and check for that.
B-Fan ordered this thing on the menu called the catfish and eggs. Let me get a try. Let's get into it.
But, so I've already reviewed pancakes, hash browns, and eggs here many times. But if what B-Fan says is true, this is going to be a redundant review. But in any case, I'm already filming. Let's get into it. I'll cut up a piece right here. Wait a second. Evergreen Inn? What are you doing? I just realized. We're eating seafood here, like fish. Where is my juicy slice of lemon?
If they want lemon, it's very nice. Don't think twice, give the guests a juicy slice.
Oh. Almost every time.
Check the archives, see if mine had the juicy slice.
All right, we'll go back and check the archives and see if B-Fan's fish had the juicy slice. But usually when you eat like fish and chips or any kind of like seafood based item, they always give you a juicy slice.
There's a juicy slice in the tartar sauce.
It's possible that they squeeze some lemon in here, but usually they just give you straight up like a slice of lemon. Like just to, because lemon, the acidity will cut away at the fishiness, so it doesn't taste as fishy. But EVN, done goofed. Where's the juicy slice? Oh man, what a shame. But let's just try this. Fish. Looks pretty crispy. See if I can get that to focus. What the hell? Who is this guy calling me in the middle of my review?
Doing good, right?
Yeah, we're doing good. B-Fan, can you read that name on my phone right now?
B-Vo.
It's Brian Vo. He's calling me while we're doing a review. You know what? I'm gonna decline this call because we're gonna have to finish this review.
Dip this real quick. Look at that tartar sauce. Let's get into it. He left me a voicemail. Okay. Oh, actually, no, that might be an old voicemail. And that catfish is really good. It's crispy. The meat, the fish is flaky. See, I can get a cross section. And the tartar sauce is actually delicious.
Does it even need the lime?
Arguably, the sauce is so good, you don't even need a lemon.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's what I'm feeling. You want to try some, Josh?
I'm good.
You're good?
Fish hater.
You're a fish hater?
At least try the tartar sauce.
Alright, I'll try a bit of the tartar sauce.
Get some of that.
Yeah, I got some gravy on my
own. Let me know what you think about that tartar sauce.
Yo, it has that very nice zing to it.
Zing
I
to
agree.
It? That's why, need the lemon. That's why I feel like there's probably some acidity already in the sauce. So you don't even need the lemon actually to squeeze on that fish. So it's good. Brian, what are your thoughts on koi?
He's going to get screwed if he wears that shirt.
Alright. You heard it from your man, B-Fan. Alright, I got a call to take, so we're going to end it at that. Catfish and eggs. We'll give it a 4 out of 5. It's pretty good. We're done here. Guys, look at that. B-Fan has a juicy slice.
If they want lemon, it's very nice. Don't think twice. Give the guests a juicy slice.
They actually messed up for me last time. Oh my goodness. Alright. First ever episode of Keto Tuesday Thrifters. What I got here is Mexican steak and eggs at Evie Inn. I've actually never had this dish on its own anyway, so this is a good chance to review it. But I'm here with the Tuesday Thrifters. B-Fan here. And then we got my comrade, my inspiration, OTH the Masu.
Over the horizon is by you.
He's the one who told me about this diet that I'm trying out right now. And of course, we got B hailing from Hollister, California. How are you doing?
Okay.
Let's make this quick, cause I'm hungry. These pieces of steak cut nice and bite-sized, and you also got bell peppers, which are safe. We checked. Onions and tomatoes. Let's get into it. That's pretty good. If you've ever had, it kind of reminds me of like fajitas. It's basically that kind of stuff, but without the tortilla, right? So the steak's decently tender. I'm gonna have to give this a 3.5 out of 5. It's slightly above average. I wouldn't say it's amazing.
Yeah, it's a little overcooked.
A little overcooked? Yeah.
Yeah, standard Mexican, nothing wrong.
Mm-hmm. It's not bad. And then we got, so I asked for substitutions. Instead of pancakes, I got a plate of avocado. And I got some cottage cheese here. Put on the record already that I'm not the hugest fan of this stuff, but you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. It tastes like cheese. It's like if you had mozzarella, and it was all mushed up and mushy and watery. Yeah, it's all right. I don't think I need to review the rest of this. This is just standard stuff, so. This Mexican steak and eggs.
Levi's.
The official shoe of the Friday Fellows.
This video is sponsored by Levi's.
I'll give it a 3.5 out of 5. I would only order this if you really like, either really like Mexican food or you are on the keto diet. Otherwise, you could go do better at EVN, like what Brandon had, the chicken fried steak and eggs, or what Brian had, the catfish and eggs, which actually had a lemon this time, the juicy slice. Any closing thoughts?
I've already reviewed this.
Yeah.
Not gonna do it again.
Literally everything has been reviewed before, so it's just a quick check-in with the Tuesday Drifters. We're done here.
Keto edition
featuring again my main man, the keto legend.
What about Alex?
Alex sadly could not be here with us today. He's actually the OG. Apparently he started keto because he was in Virginia, and he said he saw a keto drink and said no balls, and it's been a month. So big shout outs to that guy. All right. Also, shout out to my main man, FoggedFTW2, my favorite streamer to watch, who's also keto. We're done here. YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, it's your main man Wingdrops. I've already reviewed this restaurant many times before, but it's a throwback because it's the Friday Fellows, but on Monday. Name pending. I guess we'll call it Monday Meisters. Got B and B fan here. But what I'm gonna try today is what Michael calls, or I don't know what Michael calls it, but apparently his cousin likes French fries with sugar and butter. I've tried it once before when we were at Care Expo, but I didn't get it on film. So we're gonna try it here today. As a substitute for French fries, we got hash browns here, the classic Evergreen Inn hash browns. Here is a package of ambiance sugar, and I got some butter for my pancakes there. Now, let's get into it. Time to assemble the monstrosity, aka Michael's cousin's French fries. Time to ruin some perfectly good hash browns. Sprinkle lots of sugar. Take my butter knife here. Get some butter. Butter on. Wow, that looks disgusting. Alright, this is Michael's cousin's French fries going in. You know, I said it to Michael earlier, and I'll say it again, I do not recommend doing this with your potato products. Butter and sugar is an interesting combination, right? It works well on a lot of things, but in my opinion, it does not work well on potatoes. Case in point, when me and B-Fan went to that one corn dog place in H-Mart, getting the potato corn dog and rolling the sugar was not that good. Right, B-Fan?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is a similar concept. I don't know why Michael's cousin really likes this, but in my opinion, potatoes and sugar is not a good mixture, and adding butter onto it doesn't really do much either. B's got some apple pancakes over there, which fascinatingly, they're like candied apples on top. B originally thought they were going to be apples infused into the pancakes, similarly to the blueberry pancakes. You think those are good?
They're alright.
Yeah, alright, okay. It's been the Friday Fellows in a rare Monday episode. I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. Actually, it is a little bit past Christmas at the time of filming, but look at that decoration. Yeah, it's been the Monday whatevers, and we're done here.
Levi's.
The official shoe.
of the Friday Fellows. This video is sponsored by Levi's. Facebook, Twitter, it's your main man, Wingdrops, back against another
super official
food review candy give it another can. Hey, listen, man. Yo, I'm here at Evie Inn, or should I say Evie Inn and the Elegant Pub, because we're here at nighttime. First time we've come here at night, because Evie Inn now has extended hours. You can come anytime from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. Very, very excited to try the food here. I wanted to try this right here. It's called the California Scramble. Never tried this before. I wanted to try something a little lighter because this is broccoli, so it looked a little like a healthier option. Mushrooms too. It basically is scrambled eggs with broccoli, mushrooms, a little bit of meat, I think, like ham, and then drenched in hollandaise sauce and with a little bit of cheese too. And I've already had the rest of the stuff here, you know, hash browns and the pancakes. So we're gonna keep it short and just try to scramble. Let's get into it. Oh my goodness, look at that hollandaise sauce. Got a chunk of the scramble here. That's really good. It's super fresh. The sauce is piping hot, and the eggs are nice and soft. Very creamy. The creamy hollandaise sauce complements it a lot. And then you got this melted cheese. It almost it basically eats like an omelet. It's very nice. An omelet with less structure. You guys see that cheese stretch? Holy moly. This is not bad. I would say there's less eggs than I expected though. For something I call a scramble. Or maybe it's just that the hollandaise sauce is masking the flavor. But this is a pretty good dish. And it's for the price, I wouldn't say it's that bad. Because it comes with your choice of hash browns or punchy potatoes. And then you can get pancakes, toast, English muffins, etc. It's pretty darn good. I'm here today with the Friday Fellows at this beautiful patio seating here.
Levi's. The official shoe of the Friday Fellows. This video is sponsored by Levi's.
Bevo, how you doing?
You tried the chilaquiles? What do you thought about that?
I've had chilaquiles at a different brunch place and those are better, but I guess it's okay.
It's okay?
It's just a little bit like that.
Soft, a little bit crunchier. Yeah, the best part about chilaquiles is if you get them crunchy. What a shame. I was considering getting the chilaquiles here too because they were the new item. I was always, whenever I went to Evergreen Inn before, I would always look for it on the menu, but I couldn't find it. I was like, dang, where's the chilaquiles? But now they have it on the menu, and now next time I'll definitely probably want to try it. Turn it over to B-Fan, who's enjoying his ranch burger here. Let him finish his bite first. What do you think about your ranch burger?
I was expecting it to have ranch in it.
No ranch dressing?
This is mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise. Oh, what the? Baited. Unfortunate. Is it good still?
It's well enough.
Well enough.
I'm hesitant about the green chili though.
The green chili?
It seems to go. Well, green chili alone, I try to avoid it, but with everything else along with it, it seems fine so far.
Okay. Compare it to the Crown Garden Burger from LKT and Grill.
LKT and Grill's the best.
Better burgers?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, it's been your main man Wingdrops with the Friday Fellows, keeping this review nice and short because, you know, it's pretty noisy in here. Maybe not the best ambiance for a food review. We're done here.
I'm very sorry, but this guy's video sucks.
It's a solid 6 out of 10. Yo, Annie, basically.
Subscribe, like the video.
Yes, my Jared. Friends.
It's time to...
That's the good one. Mamma Mia.
Mamma Mia.
Hey, that's pretty good.